Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to this post-match press conference, Orlando City against CF Montreal. In the first group match of the Leagues Cup 2024, Coach Oscar Pareja here with us. Congratulations, Coach, on effective performance tonight. Your initial thoughts?
Well, first, it's a great night for us in front of our fans to score 4 goals. Against a very difficult rival, and you see the team in that evolution that we are looking for. Keep that momentum that we had in the last 6 games, and it's all good to see. First half, we solved the game early in terms of just being sharp on scoring. We knew that Montreal will come to look for us in the second half, and they will just give us some spaces, and that was what happened. And then again, we are fine in front of the goal, and this is something that just makes us look very good. So happy with the result, but as this competition tells us, we need to get ready for the next one.
Thanks. We have a full house. Let's start with Austin here in front.
Oscar, within your last 6 games this past month, you've scored 18 goals. I think three of those 6 games, you were able to score first and get a result. How important was that first goal from Dagger in the 7th minute to set the tone for the rest of the mm-hmm. game and really kind of ride that wave through the first half and onward?
It was a problem that we have in the first semester. It just gave us difficulties to open the games, and we were always chasing or coming from behind. And the fact that the boys are much precise in that last piece of the field and finalizing our sequences and being sharp on the finishing, it just make the other things that we do much better. And again, in the first semester, we probably did a lot of those things, but without finishing, doesn't look good. So today, the boys are sharp, and that makes a huge difference.
Oscar, congratulations on the win. Having played Montreal twice already this season and drawing both those games, did you find anything else, any new way to attack them, or is it just a matter of the team being in form and that's what made the performance look so much better in this occasion?
Right, and Michael, in the first game we played here in the opener, we played well, but we were not fine in that last piece of the field. We create probably more sequences and we create more chances than today. And the metrics and numbers tell us that, but when you are not fine in front of the goal, and then you don't win games. And then this week, I review that game and I review the other game that we played at the place. And the big difference is that we're sweet and around the box now. We having players in a very good individual moment, and that changed the whole picture. But in terms of strategy, we know that they like the ball. We know that they like to build from behind and sometimes make you feel that you are not being a protagonist of the game. But we felt comfortable on not having the ball in those periods, knowing that we were vertical and creating troubles and options, clear options to score. So we deal with that problem in a good way, and our transition and the way we attack the box, it was very good.
Right here in the middle, and then in back.
¿Qué tal, profe? Muy buenas noches. Felicidades por la contundente victoria. Quería preguntarle, justamente hablábamos con Facundo Torres sobre este cambio que ha tenido en no solo en ataque, pero en defensa. Es un nuevo jugador, está metiendo goles, metiendo asistencias, y él dijo de que no sabía a cierta cierta por qué siempre se le daba que cuando empezaba la temporada estaba un poquito flojo y de ahí mejoraba y metía todos los goles. ¿Usted específicamente qué piensa de esta evolución de Facundo y qué atributos le ve ahora como un líder dentro del grupo.
Yo creo que Facu se ha acomodado muy bien a un ajuste posicional que hicimos. Lo regresamos otra vez a la derecha porque él nos estaba haciendo funciones en la izquierda similar a las que hizo hoy. Y en la derecha encontró ese impulso, encontró el gol, confianza. Entonces se levantó el nivel de él, pasaron la confianza. Y lo mismo Martín, Ramiro. Entonces yo creo que esa fuerza colectiva los mejora a todos, ¿no? Y yo creo que han alcanzado un nivel individual muy bueno. Eso me parece. Just regarding Facu's moment and the way he's performing and the way he has changed, because it seems like the first semester they look quiet. But I have seen that when we change his position and he's playing in the right, and with the evolution of Martin and Ramiro, now we can see much more the protagonism of Facundo. So, and he's scoring goals that immediately just raise his confidence.
Buenas noches. Mi nombre es Javier García del Florida National News. Buenas noches y felicidades su victoria el día de hoy. El último partido, Ramiro Enrique mencionó acerca de su ética profesional futbolística. Y pregunta la siguiente: ¿cuáles son los puntos más relevantes de la ética profesional futbolística de Oscar Pareja?
Bueno, mira, yo creo que y chévere porque estamos hablando de eso con los muchachos ahora después del partido. Nuestro equipo se ve bien cuando respetamos nuestra ética y cuando todos entendemos de que hay que correr, hay que meter, y jugar bien o no es una consecuencia del juego que es impredecible. Pero hay códigos que no son negociables, y los chicos que están haciéndolo hoy lo están haciendo con esa ética que usted menciona. Entonces, se ve mucho mejor, nos vemos más colectivos, nos vemos más un equipo fuerte físicamente. Eso nos alegra mucho. The question is regarding a topic that we brought in the locker room after the game with the players, is that our ethics collectively has been tremendous, has been very good, and Ramiro Enrique mentioned it, but I say this is the way we are. We this is Orlando City in the last 4 years and a half, a team that sacrifices, that runs, that push, that sometimes plays well and some other times don't, but that those things that are non-negotiable are now in the pitch again, so we're happy to see it.
Let's go online. We have Sergio Venegas. Sergio, you should be able to ask your question now. Se puede hacer la pregunta.
Yeah, gracias. Thank you very much. This is Sergio Venegas from Pizarra Deportiva Mexico City. At first, I do the question in English and then in Spanish, that you can respond on both ways. What you need to improve on, first of all, congratulations on your victory, coach. Second, what you need to improve for getting through the perfect team or the perfect way that you imagine this team evolving into the tournament. Coach, ¿qué es lo que requiere o qué requiere ajustar para que su equipo sea el idóneo y poder avanzar a la siguiente ronda? Gracias, coach, y le deseo éxito.
Bueno, gracias. Happened when we can see the penalty, that first it wasn't necessary that we dropped that much, and it was a moment where I thought we felt so confident on the game and we lose concentration. So I think it's this game at this level, the level of concentration has to be for 90 plus minutes, and it's the way you should do it all the time. So I guess that in that regards we need to improve, and the boys were discussing it there. So we have our moments, the other team has their moments, but again, there's our concentration, our discipline, those those things that one of you guys called it ethics in the team, that we don't negotiate it, and that's what make me feel that this is the right direction that we're going.
Gracias, Sergio. Aquí enfrente.
Oscar, you talked about Facu, and obviously Ramiro has scored goals in five straight games, but the form of this team really seemed to improve when Martin Ojeda really got going. I think across the league, we're starting to see what Martin Ojeda, what the club saw in Martin Ojeda to bring him here. Has he arrived, or is there more that you've seen that Ojeda can he raise his game to even another level, or is this what we're seeing, the Martin Ojeda that you expected?
Right, Martin. Martin get his momentum once he improve as well his fitness and that physical condition that he knows that is required to perform at that level as a DP and as a protagonist of the team and somebody who can carry the team in his shoulders. And Martin raised all those numbers, and I think he's now rewarding by the game, and the players are so happy with him, knowing that it's not that we didn't have that before, it's that he's complementing all those things that he has with his physical condition that is incredible, one of the best in the team. So that immediately connects other things. He take a set place and they were very dangerous, most dangerous. He's always looking on taking a shot or producing something, and may not be so the guy who organized the team, but he's vertical, and we are embracing that. We need it. We like it. Facu can help us with other things, but again, Michael, I think his professionalism and the way he's taking care of his body and everything is an example for us.
If I'm correct, I think Nico took a shot, and then I just saw the ball come to me, and I thought, well, I'll just shoot it. Took a touch and shot it, and thankfully it went in, so it was a happy feeling. Pretty great.
So overall performance from the team, getting four goals, continuing this really hot run of form, scoring 18 goals this month. I mean, can you kind of put it in perspective?
It's amazing feeling, I would say. Just frustrating that we can't see this goal. I would say it's unnecessary. But it's a great feeling that we're scoring a lot of goals and we're winning games now, so it's a great feeling.
It was a pass from Wilder in the first half. You control it and you dribble the goalkeeper, but it was kind of like a light contact. But you didn't decide to dive and you decided to like keep going with the ball. What went through your mind?
My thought is just always to stay on the feet if I can, and I felt like he didn't touch me that much and I could stay on my feet, so maybe I should have shot it, but my feeling was Ramiro was coming, and I just thought I'll let him take the shot. And in the end, we missed the chance, but maybe it would have scored. Like, it doesn't matter. But my at least thought is always stay on my feet if I can, and I did it there, so I'm gonna keep doing that.
The game was 4-1, and then it came the PK. How important was the save by Pedro Galese?
Amazing. I mean, he's one of the best keepers in MLS and in America, and he's captain of Peru, so he's a great keeper and great guy. So it was amazing, and it was an amazing save, and important because I felt like we were a little bit slowing down, which is not good. So yeah, it was amazing, good.
What is the team's approach to this event, this competition? What do you guys want to accomplish? What's a successful League Cup run for you?
Win it. That's the only thing. We go into it to win it. If we don't go into it to win it, why are we then competing? It's just the mindset. We go into every competition to win. We're going to win every trophy that we can. If not, why are we here?
How important was it to get that first goal and set the tone for the game, and especially so early on?
It was good. Very good. I was very happy, like, finally to get, like, a, you could say, not a goal. I feel like all of my goals have been, like, a one-touch where I'm just, like, doing, the ball is coming and I'm just putting it there, but there, this was, like, kind of a finish, so it was a good feeling.
There's a lot of young guys coming in the second half, like Yutaro Sukada, Alex Freeman. What do you guys usually talk about in practice,
they're great players. I mean, Freeman he's a right back originally, but he can play a lot of positions, and he's an amazing player. I would say he's one of the most gifted players that I've seen as a right back, and I didn't know, but when he was younger, he played as a striker, so he can play everywhere. And Yutaro is very shifty and a great player, so they know what they're supposed to do when they come in, so they do good.
Pero bueno, una historia importante, pero de repente lo más crucial fue tu tapada de penal, porque venía 4-1 el equipo y parecía que Montreal quería remontar ese 4-1. Y ¿qué sabías? Bueno, ¿qué sabes? Porque los has enfrentado a Jason Martínez, pero ¿qué pasó por tu cabeza? La postura que sale ese penal que atajaste es importante para la victoria.
Sí, tenía que esperar hasta el último. Sabía cómo ejecuta Joseph. Y bueno, gracias a Dios pude ayudar al equipo a mantener esa tranquilidad que tuvimos en todo el partido.
Yeah, you have to wait until the last minute, especially with how Joseph takes his penalties. So you have to wait, and in those moments right before, you have to maintain your calm and just focus on what's about to happen.
Davor mencionaba que eres uno de los mejores porteros de la liga, que eres una buena persona, excelente también como profesional. ¿Cómo te sientes que tus compañeros saben que cuando más el equipo necesita estás ahí presente?
No, yo siempre trabaja para el equipo, para ver cómo están los compañeros, cómo está el grupo. No, feliz por el comentario de Daur. Y bueno, Orlando, creo que estamos para más.
Yeah, one always works for the team and for the group, so to have that praise of the group, you know, it makes me very happy to hear Dagger's comments, but just very happy with that.
Jugaron ya dos veces contra Montreal, y esa es la tercera vez que se enfrentan con una victoria contundente. ¿Cómo pareja les dijo afrontar el partido con este equipo de Montreal que vino acá a Intercoste?
No, sabíamos que Montreal venía a hacer su partido. Estábamos en casa, teníamos que aprovechar eso. Este campeonato es corto, así que la primera victoria siempre es importante.
Yeah, you know, we've already played Montreal twice this year, but this time we were playing them at home, so you know, we have to approach the game like that. This tournament's a short one, so getting that first victory is really important.
Speaking of setting the tone, you get the early goal. How important was that for Orlando City to settle into the game?
Hablando del tono para tener ese gol muy temprano en el partido, ¿cómo fue tan importante para ese equipo tener ese gol?
Sí, irse con ese marcador en el primer tiempo, creo que nos dio mucha tranquilidad de manejar el partido, de manejar los tiempos. Se nos complica un poco con el primer gol de ellos porque podía ser que reaccionen, pero creo que siempre fuimos muy superiores.
Yeah, I think obviously to have those goal scorers in the first half, it filled us with a lot of calm, gave us the confidence to be able to manage the game, manage those halves, and really control the game. But I think also after their first goal, I think the team reacted well, and we were really able to control the game, and we were the better team today. Gracias, Pedro.
Gracias.
Honestly, yeah, it's nice to be back, but I think it was my first start after 2 months. I felt that I am rusty. I don't have this confidence in my passes, but I think it's gonna come back because just after a long time without starting, without playing 90 minutes, I just feel I lost it a little bit. So, but it's a matter of time to get it back. Yeah, it's of course super nice, and you just by every single goal you score, you just grow and the confidence grows, and it's much easier to get back, I think.
Start off the tournament with a win. You got another big game coming up, San Luis, to play to get out of the group. You guys have to feel like you're in a good position after getting this win tonight.
Yeah, I think we all know that two teams go to the knockout stage, so we did a huge part in this already. So, but of course, also the next game we go after new 3 points, and because we are again competitors and we want to win every single game.
You were mentioning that you were not playing 90 minutes again, so your next game
to be honest, on training, it seems like normal. It doesn't feel like I'm rusty, if that's what you mean. But I think I need to feel relaxed, connect a little bit more with the team, and it's going to be okay. It's going to work out. Thank you, guys.
No, Fundo, tell us what you saw on your goal.
Paco, dile que miraste en tu gol.
Nada, contento por haber marcado. Pensé que me lo iban a anular, porque vi a Rama ahí cuando César tira al centro. Yo venía llegando por el segundo palo y vi a Rama ahí que estaba por definir y pensé que Rama estaba en offside, pero bueno, por suerte fue válido y pude convertir.
Yeah, obviously, very happy to be able to score the goal. On the play, I saw Ramiro going towards the center of the box, and then I saw Cesar play the ball towards him. So I just thought I'll run to the second post and be there. And then at first we thought Ramiro might be offside, but thankfully when he was able to make the play on that ball, he wasn't, and I was just able to bury it.
Is this one of those games where you're happy to get the win, but you feel like you should have scored more goals?
Es un partido esta noche que estás contento para a tener la victoria, pero en el fin del partido siente cómo puede marcar más.
Sí, yo creo que el equipo un poco se relajó en el inicio de la segunda parte. Podríamos haber marcado más goles. Yo creo que el equipo empezó un poco a tener la pelota y no era esa la idea de juego. Y ahí fue donde ellos consiguieron los goles y nada, después el equipo se dio cuenta que había que seguir atacando, pero yo creo que sí, que podríamos haber marcado más goles. Si hubiéramos seguido jugando como estábamos jugando la primera parte.
Yeah, I think that's accurate. I think we probably could have scored more goals tonight. I think at the start of the second half, the team relaxed a little bit more, and we had the ball, but we didn't have a clear idea of what we wanted to do with it. And then after that, we got together again and remembered that we had to continue attacking, and thankfully we were able to score again. But at the end of it, yeah, I think we probably could have scored more tonight.
Okay. What has been the catalyst to this offensive turnaround where you had so many multi-goal games?
Este equipo se marcó 18 goles en este mes. Solo en este mes. ¿Qué fue el cambio para este equipo para tener ese suceso en el ataque?
No, cambio no. Yo creo que ahora nos están saliendo las cosas que cuando iniciamos la temporada no nos estaban saliendo mucho. Estaba un poco complicado y por suerte ahora venimos mejorando y el equipo está marcando goles y se está haciendo fuerte también defensivamente.
Yeah, I don't think there was a change or a catalyst. I think we've always worked this hard. I think at the beginning of the season it was difficult for us. You know, we weren't scoring a whole lot, so it was a little bit more difficult. But I think the team just continued to work, and thankfully now things are starting to go our way, and the ball's starting to go in the back of the net.
Bueno, en lo físico se ve el equipo sube más bajo, inclusive a veces se ve la prensa que hay una línea de seis, contigo como Ojeda de como laterales y los cuatro en línea. ¿Qué ha cambiado? O sea, ¿por qué eso? Quizás el estado anímico, la confianza ha crecido. Y también te quería preguntar sobre qué importante para el equipo fue adentro sobre la tajada de Pedro Pérez en el penal.
Sí, bueno, hemos conseguido esa forma de jugar que, bueno, lo que pide el profe, todos lo sabemos, que si no corremos no jugamos. Y el profe pide mucho que ayudemos en defensa. A mí me pasaba al principio, me costaba que... Cuando yo llegué aquí era solo delantero y hoy por hoy ayudo bastante la marca, que es un poco lo que pide el profe. Y a veces se nota así esa línea de seis, entre comillas, que nosotros nos estamos metiendo en la línea de cuatro. Pero es más que nada para ayudar a los compañeros defensivamente, como ellos nos ayudan ofensivamente también. Pero nada, por suerte las cosas no están saliendo. Y sobre la tajada de Pedro fue muy importante porque si no ellos se nos venían. La verdad que ahí como... pusimos un stop y ahí pudimos ganar el partido porque si no hacían ese gol se iba a complicar.
Yeah, I think following the form that we've had recently, what Oscar asked of us is that, and basically tells us is that if you don't run, you don't play. I think that's something that probably cost me a little bit when I first arrived here. I arrived thinking, you know, I'm just a forward. That's how I'm going to play. But with Oscar, that's not the way that it goes. You have to run if you want to be able to play. You have to help out defensively if you're a forward, and the defenders help out in the attack as well, thankfully. So I think now that we've all got that idea, everything moves smoother. And then obviously with the stop with Pedro is incredibly important because they weren't able to come closer to us in that game, and obviously we needed him in that moment, and he made a big stop. And then it allowed us to win the game because they couldn't, if they had scored there, things would have been a little bit more complicated at the end.
Speaking of all that running and defending, what was it like for you to have to go up against Juan to keep him quiet, and how much energy did you have to spend to keep him from hurting the team?
¿Cómo fue para ti para jugar frente a Juan? ¿Y cómo está tu energía después de ese partido frente a él?
Sí, es complicado. Sabíamos que Juan es un jugador muy rápido. Bueno, el profe me pidió especialmente que estuviera cuidado ahí con él. Trataba siempre de tenerle la ventaja porque si me igualaban la línea con él, yo sabía que él me podía ganar en velocidad, un jugador muy rápido. Y por suerte lo pude controlar bien y hice el trabajo que el profe me pidió. Y nada, pero feliz de verlo verlo jugar y estar de nuevo con él.
Yeah, obviously very complicated, right? Obviously we know going in that he would be tough to play against. Oscar asked me to make sure that I was being careful with him and with his positioning against me, because if he gets in a straight line run, he can beat you with the speed. But you know, I think we did really well helping each other out and locking him down today.
Sí, la verdad que no lo sé. Los tres años que he estado aquí me ha pasado exactamente lo mismo. Siempre empiezo, obviamente que con muchas ganas, pero no se me dan ni los goles ni la asistencia, venía un poco complicado. Y siempre los tres años me ha pasado lo mismo, que en la segunda etapa vienen todos juntos. Y nada, feliz de este momento, pero tratando sí y pensando más que nada en ese momento de la primera etapa, de poder revertir eso, de poder arrancar haciendo goles, asistencia, ayudando al equipo, como lo hago en la segunda etapa. Ojalá que pueda revertir esa parte del primer año, poder arrancar con mucha más goles y asistencia, pero nada, feliz de este momento que estoy viviendo ahora.
Yeah, the truth is right, I don't know though. All three years that I've been here have been the exact same. I enter the season with obviously a lot of hopes and a lot of objectives, and things just don't go my way. I have a tough time scoring and providing those assists in the first half, and then the second part of the year rolls around and I'm able to find myself scoring those goals, providing those assists, helping the team in any way that I can. But it's been the same in those first 3 years, where the first half has been really complicated for me, and then the second half I'm able to produce and continue helping my team. So hopefully I'm able to, as we enter the rest of the second part of the year, continue helping my team, and just really enjoying this moment right now. Gracias, Paco.
Gracias.